NXCAD software training. Let's see about Ellipse today. So I'm going for a sketching task environment. I'm going to create a new sketching plane. Now we are into the sketching plane. So let us see about Ellipse now. So generally to place any ellipse, you need a center point and you need a major radius, minor radius and an angle. And if you want a closed ellipse, you can keep this in a closed status so that the closed ellipse will get created. Suppose you wanted to have a semicircle of the ellipse, then you can turn off this button so that it will create only the semicircle. Suppose whatever the angle we want, accordingly we can create it. Okay, let's move on. So now I am going to create a ellipse, means roughly I will create it first to make you understand. I am placing one point here. So this is my center point of the ellipse. So I am going to give some parameters here. Major radius, I am giving it as 1000. Okay. And the minor radius, I am going to give it as 500. Okay. And the rotation angle, I wanted to make it as 30 degree. Okay. I made it. Now it is in the closed state so that only you are getting a full radius. Okay. Full full ellipse you are getting it now. Suppose I am turning off it, you will get the semicircle based on the angle whatever we define. Suppose I'm defining it as 45 degree, only for this 45 degree angle I will get a ellipse like this. Suppose I'm going for 90, I will get off. Okay, I'm going for 180, means you will get exactly semi ellipse, you will get it. Now I'm going for 270, means you will get like this. 360, means full ellipse you will get it. So this is how this ellipse option will work. Now I am keeping this as a closed button only so that the complete ellipse, complete full ellipse I will get it. So you can see the preview also now. So this is how it will get created. Okay, let's apply now. So now we have selected the ellipse and we created it. Now we can see still it requires a three constraints. Why it needs a three constraints? Already we defined all the parameters in line to the requirement. Because of it requires one center point, I given the center point, and the major radius and the minor radius I have provided already. So these are all the parameters have been converted into ellipse now. So then why it is still requires three constraints? That is one question. Another one is the ellipse will not be fully constrained automatically. So here you can notice in the queue status line, the ellipse will not be fully constrained automatically. That is what the queue line statement it says. Yes, exactly. The ellipse cannot be fully constrained whatever the parameters we defined here. So generally, this won't be fully constrained because of the reason why it cannot be fully constrained is, we can see now. Because of this curve is also belongs to the geometrical constraint. Because of that, this ellipse cannot be fully constrained. To do this ellipse to be fully constrained, we have to go in a other way. So here also you can see the automated dimensions, whatever it is created only for the center point, not for the major axis and not for the minor axis. Even if you go for the expressions also, suppose we have for each and every dimension there is a expressions are created, even whatever the parameters were given through this ellipse button, through this parameters button, everything will get created as a expressions only. So let's see the expression what it has got created now. I will explain you. So go to tools option, there is expression toolbar is present. You can see here, so no values are present anywhere. The 1000 major axis and 500 minor axis, everything we specified, but nothing is present here because of this ellipse is not purely a parametric one. Even though it comes under the sketch and it comes under the ellipse, that dialog box, the whatever the value is specified, it will take it. It cannot be fully constrained by automatically. So how to make that constraint, that is what we are going to see today. Since it's a interesting topic, I wanted to cover this as a separate feature, so that's why I'm taking up today. So let's see now again. So now I'm going to do this ellipse as a fully constrained. How to do that I'm going to tell now. Please make a note of it. So now I'm going for the center point. So the center point while I'm going, I'm selecting this control point and I'm selecting this point option wherever it is. Okay. So this origin of this datum coordinate system, I'm selecting it. So this I got selected now. So origin got selected. Okay. Whatever the major radius and minor radius you want, it doesn't matter. Whatever the shape you want, you just design it. So I am considering that this is my major axis and this is my minor axis, so that I am considering my profile like this. Okay. approximately like this. Suppose you are considering that this is your major axis, means you create a profile like this. Okay, you no need to worry about the dimension, only you just think of that which is major axis and which is minor axis. So whatever the way you wanted to control, you can control it in the profile. I wanted to control like this, don't worry about the size. Okay, right, so this is the major axis, this is the minor axis I'm considering. Okay, let it be like this. Okay, and the angle and all I'm not giving now. So whatever the angle it has come, already by default it is having a 30 degree, so that I'm leaving it with the same option. Okay, now you give okay. So to do this, now what I'm going to do, now automatic dimensions are there that I do not want, so that you can switch off it. Even already it is got created for a 00, you can delete it also, no problem. Okay, no expressions, nothing is linked here. No continuous auto dimension is also not there. You can see here sketch needs fully sketch needs 5 constraints over here. So this point is still open now. I'm going to make this point to be constrained to this point. Okay, so that is the only step I wanted to do. So I done it now. Okay, right. Now I am going to create a small profile line. So with reference to this ellipse center, I wanted to create it vertically like this, perpendicularity to this ellipse I am creating it. Okay, perpendicular to this ellipse I am creating it. Similarly, one more line I am going to create it from the same center point horizontally. Horizontally means perpendicular to this vertical line. I am going to create one more perpendicular line like this. Okay, now. So what I want is actually this ellipse I wanted to control in line to this edges only, so that I am trimming these lines in line to this. Okay, right. So now I am going to define the dimensions. How I am going to define the dimension is, you can see here I am going for rapid dimension. Here you can see there is a perpendicularity option is there, so that's what I am going to select it. Select this line and select this ellipse perimeter of any of the location. Either you can select here also, or else either you can select here also. So to do properly, you need to select this line just like that, so that I am turning off all the options except this point, tangent point. Okay, just to select this tangent point, so that this dimension will get generated like this. And similarly, we can go for one more option. Horizontally, I wanted to control this distance, this major radius distance I wanted to control. So the same way I'm going to control it, perpendicularity I wanted to control from this line to this arc. Okay, tangent point I wanted to select it. So this has got selected now. Okay, by this way you can able to control these two dimensions. And one more dimension I wanted to control it, because of now sketch needs only one constraint. You can see now, so only the rotation angle is still remaining. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give an angular constraint. So to angular constraint, you can go for angular dimension. Go for angular dimension from here, select this axis, select this line, so that you will get an angle dimension like this. So now I'm going to change it as 30 degree. So this is how you can make the sketch to be fully constrained. You can see now the sketch is fully constrained. And the lines in the middle, whatever we have created, I do not want these lines to be active line. It is a reference line only for construction of this ellipse. I wanted to create it so that I can make these two lines to be a reference line, so that it won't be used for any of the profile creations. Okay, so to do any lines as a reference line, select this line, make a right click, convert to reference. There is an option called convert to reference, so this will get converted into reference, so that these lines cannot be used for any extrude or revolve or anything. As a profile, it will not get generated. For axis, we can use this. Okay, similarly, this vertical line also, you can select this and make a right click, and you can convert to reference, or else from this pop-up toolbar also you can do that. For example, now you can select this, right, sorry, select this. And you can see here, convert to reference button is available. You can just click on this so that it will get generated into reference line. So this is how we are converting any normal line into, that is active line into reference line. So this is how the sketches also, ellipse also got fully constrained. Okay, so this is the way the sketch has to be, ellipse sketch has to be created. Otherwise, you cannot make it fully constrained. Okay, by default this ellipse will not be in a fully constrained state. We have to make that to be a fully constrained state by using these lines. Okay, so let's see in the next class. Thank you.
If you have any doubts or clarifications, please write or comment. My email ID is nx.sureshg@gmail.com. Please subscribe to my channel, NX CAD Software Training. Click on the bell icon to get the notification. Thank you.